I rise in support of families and the women of Pennsylvania. I rise in opposition to this bill. I ask you to imagine a pregnant woman in her doctor's office, sitting with her partner, reviewing test results. It's a small room with white walls. There's an emotional and very personal conversation. Now imagine squeezing into that small doctor's office, along the walls and between the woman and her doctor, the 203 members of this legislative body. It's as ridiculous as it sounds. Wedging ourselves into that emotional and personal decision, especially given that the courts have already firmly upheld that woman's right to make a decision. Maybe she's a woman over age 35. So as part of her standard medical care, she has genetic testing done. If this legislation were to be enforced, it would incite fear and have a chilling relationship on the very important relationship that exists between a pregnant woman and her doctor. Because if she has those test results in hand, showing the sex and the genetic condition, how on earth could that woman possibly prove she didn't take any of that information into account when making her decision? And how could she possibly feel comfortable asking her doctor important follow-up questions about those results if this legislation, in fact, was the lay of the land? This bill is about one thing: taking away power from the women of Pennsylvania. I would like to echo some of the comments made by my colleagues, because I oppose this bill on behalf of every family that includes a person with Down syndrome who fights for essential support and services that are in too short supply. If this bill was truly about supporting people with Down syndrome in this Commonwealth, I believe it would address the wait list that was already mentioned by my colleague, Representative Miller. It does not, which I believe shows the true intention of this bill. If we actually wanted to support women, babies, and a strong society, there are things we could do. We would invest in lowering the maternal mortality rate, increasing services for postpartum depression, paid family leave, universal pre-K, Medicare for all, and raising the minimum wage. That's how we help Pennsylvania families. I truly look forward to those legislative conversations. But today, on this bill, Mr. Speaker, I am a no, because I oppose this legislature tearing away the rights of women in Pennsylvania. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.